Good evening and welcome home. I'm Michael Thompson DeGrief and I serve here at Trinity with Pastor Kim Beery, and we are delighted that you're celebrating Christmas Eve with us tonight. I want to let you know that the offering that we'll take later in the service will go to support an important ministry to our church, the Circles of Hope of Reno County, which helps families here in our community to get to work their way out of poverty. And so we appreciate your support of that important ministry. And now I'd like to invite you to stand and let's join together in the call to worship.
God of all ages, in the birth of Jesus Christ,
bright light of your boundless love consumes the power of darkness.
Tonight, may your love and light be born in us,
that our song may blend with all the choirs of heaven and earth to the glory of your name. Amen.
From the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of the oppressor, they have been broken as on the day of Midian. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
This night is a night to remember, a night when home broke in on us, a night when we were not forgotten or alone or abandoned. This night is a night when here and there became one, when past and future combined in a breathless present. This is a night when we are home in ourselves, in this family, in the God who loved us enough to walk beside us.
We gather in the night to proclaim the light.
We shrug off despair and embrace hope.
We set aside conflict and choose peace.
We push away despair by claiming joy.
We overcome hate by rising into love.
Because this night we know
Even in the shadows of our doubts,
we know that we are loved.
That's what it means to be home.
We light these candles hoping to become the light, hoping to radiate light by how we live. We light these candles to create a space called home in this place, in our place, in inner places. We light these candles to declare that unto us a Savior is born, who is Christ the Lord. Welcome home by angels singing and shepherds kneeling. Welcomed home by those like us who have worshiped for thousands of years. Welcomed home again tonight, right here, right now, in us.
It's time to be home.
We have gathered from many different places. We are at different stages and seasons in our lives. This may be a really joyful time for you. This may be a hard, worrisome, difficult time. Know that the Christ Child Savior hears your prayers. Let's prepare ourselves in silence for a time of prayer. God of Christmas, your name is still called Wonderful, Mighty God, the Prince of Peace. As your children, we cry out for a fresh filling and a new awareness of who you are. We choose by faith to make the good news of great joy a reality in our own lives, so others can see us as lighted trees of life, pointing to you this Christmas. We know one day every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that you are Lord. And we also know that peace on earth can only come when hearts find peace with you. You are still our joy. You are still our peace. You are no longer a babe in the manger. You are the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. And we still celebrate you as Lord this Christmas and always. Amen.
Emmanuel.
us experience the gospel story found in Luke describing the birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. The word of God for the people of God.
Did you know that your baby boy would someday walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss their little baby, then you kiss the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that that your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am.
Thank you, Alex. When I was a child, my favorite decoration to set up was the nativity. Nativities have a special place in my heart. In fact, my parents' nativity was a special gift that they received for their first Christmas as a married couple from my grandma and grandpa DeGrief. My grandpa had built the stable out of wood and had spray-painted some white frost on there to look like snow. And he attached this large Christmas light up underneath the roof that just created this glorious golden glow over the figures in the stable. And every Christmas, I look forward to getting that box out and carefully unwrapping each one of the figures, each one of the animals, and just pondering this story of the birth of Jesus. I found it all just mysterious and wonderful. Now, when my wife Stephanie and I got married, I was waiting with anticipation for Christmas, because I really hoped that my parents would give us our first nativity as a married couple. And that Christmas, my parents came through, and they continued the DeGrief family tradition. You're actually looking at the very nativity that my parents gave to us for our first Christmas there. I was so filled with emotion when they gave it to us, I cried tears of joy. And as soon as we got home, I set up the nativity in our house, and it felt like we were finally ready to have Christmas together. Now, someday we will continue that tradition with our boys. There's our four boys. Some of them are here this evening. And someday we're going to give our four boys their own nativities to set up in their homes with their families. Our oldest son, the one on the far left with the beard there, he is now a high school history teacher at Washburn Rural High School in Topeka, Kansas. But he wasn't always the man you see there with that beard. He was a little guy, and here's a picture of him 20 years ago. He was a big Blues Clues fan. When Zach was a little guy, he was really into animals. I mean, like, he was obsessed with animals. He loved going to the zoo. He loved reading books about animals. He collected animals. In fact, he had this very large collection of little rubber animals that people would continue to give him more and more animals, and we would buy them everywhere we went. And every time Zach got a new rubber animal, he had this ritual of taking a bath with the rubber animals, and he would line them up all around the edge of the bathtub, and then he would take the new animal and dip it in the water to welcome it into his family of animals. It was very much like a baptism into the community. It was very special. And Zach loved his rubber animals. Now, one day during the Advent season, I came home after a long day at church to find little Zachary setting up all of his rubber animals around the nativity. All the elephants, the lions, the giraffes, the snakes, the sharks, the stingrays, the beetles, everything carefully placed so that their gaze was focused on the centerpiece, which was the baby Jesus in the manger. In Zach's sweet little mind, it made sense that the animals that were so dear to him should gather around for this special event, the birth of Jesus, so that the animals could meet the Christ child and welcome him into the family and pay homage to him. It was quite a sight to see. This enormous crowd of animals around the table, it looked like Noah's Ark meets the Lion King. Can you picture that? Yeah, it was just this celebration. It was like all of creation, every living being was drawn together by God's love to worship the newborn king. It's like that hymn, Joy to the World, like, let heaven and nature sing, right? Let heaven and nature sing. And it was such a blessing. And it's what we all need right now, especially if you're going through a time of darkness or fear or loss or sorrow. So may all of us gather our loved ones around the Christ child in the stable so that together we may find a home for our wandering hearts and find rest for our weary souls. Amen.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul the slave is a brother. and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Oh, praise his name forever. His power and glory evermore proclaim. His
Our offering this evening will be used in the Circles of Hope Community Initiative to assist families with limited resources to better their circumstances. You can make a difference in the lives of families through your generous giving.
Thank you. the Spirit, Holy Spirit.
Be seated. Join me in the Litany of Light. Lord, you will never abandon your people in the darkness of sin and death.
You are truly our light and salvation. Whom shall we fear?
Your word is a lamp unto our feet and light unto our paths.
We shall delight in your wisdom all the days of our lives.
For you light a path for the righteous.
Like the light of dawn, which shines brighter and brighter each day.
Jesus Christ is the Word made flesh.
Like the light of all people who shines in the darkness.
Jesus is the light of the world.
Whoever follows him will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Please remain seated.
And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven, heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns, let all their songs implore. While fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, we beat the sounding joy, we beat the sounding joy.
Christmas. I'm going to offer the benediction and then we're going to sing Peace, Peace together. Let us pray. The light of the world has come, so go in peace, and may each of you reflect the light of God's love into the dark places in our world. Amen.
This time we invite you to extinguish your candles, sit back and relax, and enjoy one more time Joy to the World.